Normally on a bright sunny day like this, Big Spring Park would be filled with people. And while it's bright and sunny, it's also 98 degrees according to this thermometer. Being out in temperatures like this for too long can lead to heat exhaustion, which can then lead to the even worse heat stroke. Dawn Webster with HEMSI says it's important to check a few things if you think someone has may suffer from a heat-related illness.
Evaluate the person. Are they talking? Are they making sense in their communication skills? Are they staggering? Are they being able to walk straight, sit up straight, answer your questions in a normal manner?
Heat-related illnesses can start off just as heat exhaustion, where someone experiences heavy sweating, cold, clammy skin, dizziness, and fainting.
They get out and they start getting dizzy, lightheaded, their heart rate increases, start getting lightheaded, up to the point of having a syncope or passing out.
But it can lead to a heat stroke if their symptoms get worse or last longer than 20 minutes. It's important to get someone out of the sun and into cooler temperatures as soon as possible. Dawn Webster says majority of the calls were from people working outside. A spokesman with the Breland Company says none of their workers have gotten a heat-related illness this year. They try to make sure all their workers take plenty of breaks and listen to their bodies.
There are times that sometimes you just need to say, I got to take a break. You got to go maybe sit in a truck, turn on the air conditioner for a little while, catch your breath, go get a Gatorade, and decide whether or not you can come back to work or maybe you come back the next day.
It's important to continue checking in on people if they experience heat exhaustion earlier on in the day. Webster told me majority of their calls come in the early evening for heat-related illnesses. Reporting in Huntsville, Grace Campbell, Way 31 News.